What is up, guys? Mega Mad here with another pickups video for the month of October. I've been feeling a little bit under the weather, so I got a small cold, so my voice isn't quite where it should be. So just bear with me with that. Obviously, this month is not going to be nothing like last month. Some pretty good scores, but nothing crazy like last month's score. Like, I probably won't ever have a month as good as last month's, but anyway. Some good stuff though. So first thing I picked up, I actually found this at a Salvation Army and it was only $2. It was pretty dirty. I cleaned it up, tested it, all works, but it's an N64 expansion pack. These go for like $20, I think, normally, so for $2 and not gonna complain there. Went to my favorite local store, game store. And they posted some pictures on Facebook. They got some games in. This game, excuse me, this game is actually quite difficult to come by, I guess, but they had a copy of it. It's not that expensive, but this is a puzzle game, and this is called Kickle Cubicle. It's an IRM game. And one of the reasons I picked this up is I wanted to try it, but also a local collector I know, his name's Andres, he actually gave me a manual for this game, I think a couple months ago. So now I have the cart and the manual, so that's pretty cool. And then for the PS1, pretty cool shoot 'em up. Haven't gotten around to play this, but I'm pretty sure it's like the other ones. This is G Darius. Or Darius, however you say it, like Darius Twin and all the other random shmup games. And then my other buddy, Raven J. If you don't know who he is, he actually did that 8-bit huge picture behind me. He's like a local artist, plays games every once in a while. He's selling some stuff, some games he had, and this one I had to jump on. I've been looking to try it, test it out, 'cause it's pretty expensive. It's pretty high in price on the list, but he was selling it for really cheap, fairly cheap, so gave me a great deal on it. And that is for the PS2, Haunting Ground. It's like a horror game. Like I said, I haven't gotten a chance to play it yet, but I like horror games, so should be fun. Okay, so, all right, now moving on, I got some box games, which is pretty good. Some box Game Boy games. excuse me, man, I'm just feeling like poop right now. this game I found, it's a Game Boy game. The box is in fantastic shape, so is the cart and the manual. Looks like it's like only been played maybe once or twice, but complete in box on the Game Boy, Tetris. I played this, I have this on the NES, played it on the NES. I assume it's just like the other one, except just on the Game Boy. Buddy of mine told me that, I should just give it a shot. So, and it was only, I think, like $5 or something like that, so I couldn't pass that up. And then I was in there following week, and they had a couple more boxed Game Boy games, but they're Game Boy Advance games. So this one is a fighting game, Sonic Battle, and the reason I picked this up because my friend TJ Kitsune, he loves Sonic the Hedgehog. And I just picked it up and I figured he didn't have this box, but apparently he has this box already, so I don't know what I'm gonna do. I'll probably just put this up for trade or something. So, and then the other game, which I was real happy to get, pretty uncommon game to find boxed in really decent shape, that is Kirby Nightmare in Dreamland. Complete in box with the manual and everything, so. This is a fun game. It's pretty much like Kirby's Dream Land on the NES, just on the Game Boy. But really, really fun. And then the last box game I found, which these boxes are always beat up. Oh, excuse me. This is an N64 title. Every N64 box game, I seem to find the box is either beat to crap or it's bent or it's got creases in it. I mean, these just, I don't know, these boxes never hold their weight for some strange reason. But this is Yoshi's Story, complete in the box. I think I paid only $10 for this. It was just the game, no manual, but the cartridge is in like really good shape. Really nice minty shape. So I was just like, well, you know, I'll probably search down a manual. So I was just looking on eBay, and I did find a manual. I think it was like $10. So I don't know if that's not cheap or too expensive or whatever. So I got the manual, and I also got a operating guide, moving Yoshi guide with it. So. But now I have this game complete in box. So for like $20 for complete in box, that's still a great deal, I think. This, I am a monthly subscriber to a arcade. It's called Arcade Block. And for those of you who don't know that, it's part of a company called Nerd Block. Basically, you pay, it's like $20, $30 a month, and they send you a box of stuff. It's just random video game stuff. What I get is called Arcade Block, so it's all like video game related items. This was actually thrown in there this last month, so I was pretty excited to get this. This was only available on the PlayStation Vita. And it was a real limited production. I think you could still buy this game, but it's like $50-$60 on eBay, but it's out of print. But this is a CD version of it that you can play on your PC, and they put it in like a Super Nintendo box, which is pretty cool. But this is Retro City Rampage DX, and as you can see, it's just like a Super Nintendo box, but it has a CD in it, and it looks like a floppy, you know, one of them old school floppy disk drives. But really, really cool. I'm gonna have to definitely check this out. I've been told it's really, really fun. So once I get to it, my backlog is pretty crazy right now. So whenever I get around to it. Okay, a few more things left. Got a couple PlayStation 2 games. One of them's Uncommon. This I didn't have, which I'm kind of surprised I don't have this, but this has a bunch of classic Capcom games on it. Street Fighter 2, Ghosts and Goblins, Legendary Wings, 1942, but this is the Capcom Classics Collection. So that was pretty cool to score, so I can play those on my PS2. And then this one is just, I didn't even know about this game. This is a really hard to find underrated game. I haven't played it. It looks really weird. I don't know if I'm gonna test it, but if I don't like it, I'm definitely probably gonna trade it away. But it was cheap. This is Getaroo Man. I don't know if I'm saying that right. Getaroo Man. Just looking at the cover and that just looks really weird to me. So I just had to pick it up. It was cheap, so I ain't gonna complain. I got a GameCube game. The other day, this one's actually pretty uncommon to find, and when you do find it, it's up to, I think it's like $30 right now, but I got this for like $6, so my game store is just, the pricing is just so amazing there, it's just unbelievable. But this is Billy Hatcher and the Giant Egg, and it's like a Sonic the Hedgehog, it says creator of Sonic the Hedgehog. So I assume it's like Sonic the Hedgehog side-scrolling type action. So definitely going to try this out and love GameCube. So, all right, the last couple things. Me and Jason went to Madison recently, and we hit the game stores up there. This game, I was kind of surprised. This game was only $13, and it's normally a $25, $30 game. But the game store I got it from, a lot of the stuff they have is like eBay pricing, or it's like really high retail stuff, but sometimes you catch them slipping, so I caught them slipping. Apparently, they had two copies of this too, which is the same price, which is kind of outrageous. But for the Sega Genesis, I've been told this is a great title, so I'm happy to check it out once I do check it out. But this is Rocket Knight Adventures for the Sega Genesis. And it does have the manual and everything complete, so that's pretty awesome. For 13 bucks, I'm not going to complain. And then the last thing was the main reason I went to Madison. The one store we go to, it's called Video Game Exchange. Me and Jason have gone there a lot. We know the owner. He's really nice, really awesome guy. He listed this on his Facebook page, and when I saw it, I wanted it. I, like, jumped on it, messaged him right away. I'm like, please, can you hold this for me? He's like, sure, no problem. It's kind of pricey. I ended up bringing a game to trade, so we just did an even trade up for it, so happy about that, but it's got a little wear and tear on the outside, but the inside is pretty mint. But this is the Game Boy SP NES version. Now, if you guys don't know what this is basically an SP that looks like a regular Nintendo. As you can see, it's got the the grooves on the top, and the Nintendo's red, but then on the inside, it's black. Looks just like an NES controller and like a regular Nintendo. So this is pretty hard to find. I was really happy that I finally got this, but you guys, I don't know, you guys really can't see. There's some scratching on the front here, and then there is some wear on the back, but there's two different kinds of SPs. This is a 101 and a 001. Unfortunately, this is a 001. What that is a 101 has a backlit screen. This one doesn't, but it works, and it's great, and I'm just really, really happy to add that to the collection. So, and that's it for this month. Not a whole lot, but still some good quality stuff. Hopefully I get over this cold, and we'll see what next month. No, I can't talk. We'll see what next month brings. So until next time, you guys, I'll see you next time. Take care.